بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. The ayat that was recited by the Qari, may Allah bless him, you know, in the last rukah is a very powerful ayah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبَعَدُونَ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا وَهُمْ فِي مَا اشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى those who have perceived and took care and took advantage of the husna they from Allah Azza wa Jal أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبَعَدُونَ they are away from the hellfire لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا they are not going to be exposed to the you know the noise of the fire. You know how when the fire is raging, it's so terrifying. لا يسمعون حسيسا وهم في ما اشتهت أنفسهم خالدون. And they are in what their nafs would be happy to enjoy, are engaged, are indulged, which is al-Jannah. Now, this is an introduction to what I was planning to talk about today. We are now halfway through the month of Ramadan almost. And just like what we predicted from the beginning of Ramadan, we said before we know it, the month is going to be gone and, you know, we will be concluding. Now, did we feel the impact of Ramadan? Did we feel that Ramadan is giving that chance to us for us to be feel the khushu', to feel, you know, the feeling that of being with Allah Azza wa Jal? Because Allah says in the Quran, يا أيها الناس قد جاءتكم موعظة من ربكم وشفاء لما في الصدور. O people, mankind, not believers, mankind, there has come to you from Allah Azza wa Jal موعظة, a reminder, وشفاء لما في الصدور, and a healing to what's in the hearts, meaning to say what's in the chest, meaning to say the hearts. وهدى ورحمة للمؤمنين, and it is guidance and رحمة to the believers. قل فضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرح وهو خير مما يجمعون. Say this is what you should be happy with, that Allah Azza wa Jalla had given to you, better than what you will be accomplishing from this dunya. خير مما يجمعون, whatever you accomplish from this dunya will be nothing. Whatever you will be getting from the Quran is the gain. Now, يعني سبحان الله, as I said, and month of Ramadan is month of Rahman. It's a season of barakat, and you know we see ourselves busy and going around trying to accomplish things. But did we get what we want from Ramadan? Yes, indeed. For businesses, it is a chance to make money. There's nothing wrong with it. You know, for you know all of us, it's a time for us to be able to get things done and organized. طيب. But where is it beyond that? Ramadan is there to change our nafs, to make us feel the khushu'. You know, Allah Azza wa says in Surah Al-Zumar, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ فَوَّيْلٌ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِّنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أُولَئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ أُولَئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. Allah Azza wa Jalla has said, is it, you know, as for the one whom Allah Azza wa Jalla has expanded his chest, لِلْإِسْلَامِ to Islam, فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ, he is walking on a nur of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And quite the opposite, فَوَيْلْ, oh we to those whose hearts are cruel, hard, as a result that the فَوَيْلْ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, oh we unto those whose hearts are so hard for the lack of remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jalla, أُولَئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ, they are in a you know big ضلال, clear ضلال. الله نزل أحسن الكتاب الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثاني تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم لذكر الله. يا الله, Allah is saying to you that here comes to you a book Allah عز وجل have revealed حديث saying in a كتاب متثاني that is repeated تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم. When you recite it, you will have the goosebumps. Your skin will feel the impact, and as a result of that, your hearts will shiver, and you'll feel the impact of the Quran in your heart. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla, Surah An-Nur, which is recited also earlier today, that Allah says, "Allahu nuru al-samawati wal-ard." Allah is the nur of the skies and earth. مثل نوري كمشكاتن فيها مصباح المصباح وفي زجاجة. The example of the nur of Allah Azza wa Jalla is giving us to us in a metaphor in the Quran. But you know, we don't want to spend much time to talk about this beautiful metaphor that is explaining the nur of Allah Azza wa Jalla. But this nur of Allah Azza wa Jalla is available to whom? في بيوت أذن الله أن يرفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والأصال رجال. It is available for those who have made the houses of Allah Azza wa Jal a place where they are able to gain the nur of Allah Azza wa Jal. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والأصال. There are those who will be praising their Lord early in the morning and in the evening. رجال. Who are the رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. They are people of integrity, because رجال could not is not only given to male, it could be given to females by the way, but it refers to integrity. People of integrity, who is the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, who is their businesses with not distracting from the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. So that's what we need to keep in mind. My brother, my sister is also included into this. If you did not plan to do i'tikaf in the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan, you don't know what you're depriving yourself from. If it's not possible, do not deprive yourself on weekends, on long weekends, on times when you are not at work. Just put your phone on silent or turn it off. Trust me, you are not going to be more busy than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No matter what busy, how busy you are, the life will go on. Trust me. Your business is going to survive. Everything else will be taken care of. Give chance for yourself to taste the sweetness of being with Allah Azza wa Jal during the month of Ramadan while you're connecting in the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, whether it's in the Quran recitation or other forms of remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيه بالغدو والأصال رجال لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة يخافون يوم تتقلب فيه القلوب والأبصار ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله والله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Let's live these آيات in whatever left from the month of Ramadan. As I said again, do not deprive yourself from hours or days of isolation, as the Prophet ﷺ used to do in i'tikaf. خلاص, isolate yourself from everything around you. This is the most distractive, gadget we have, the phones. Put it away, خلاص يا أخي, no need for it. Focus on your ibadah. Let your heart, absorb the healing power of the Quran. So you're able by the end of Ramadan feel that, alhamdulillah, that I have done something. May Allah Azza help us to be able to understand and benefit and to take advantage of this beautiful, magnificent gift from Allah Azza that is called Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.